is going to bless us abundantly in Jesus' name. Those who have never seen miracle like this close by today, you will see it. Because the Lord will bless our lives in Jesus' name. Just close your eyes and raise your hands to heaven and say, Lord, I am here, remember me. 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 The Lord is looking at you now. He's looking upon you now. He remembers you. He remembers you. He remembers you. You will never be forgotten. Heaven is going to pour abundance into your life today. In Jesus' name we pray. Almighty God, we thank you for such a good day like this. You brought your people together so that you can pour abundance from heaven upon everyone. Oh Lord, I pray that those hidden treasures and those unlimited riches today, they will fill our lives in Jesus' name. Lord, the weak will be strong. The sick will be healed. The simple will be made righteous. The joy of the Lord will be our strength in Jesus' name. Your people are blessed. Everyone, Lord, will taste of your goodness even from today in Jesus' name. Take sorrow away from every heart. Shame away from every life. Sickness from everyone. I pray, oh Lord, that your people will never be the same again in Jesus' name. Open those doors. Open those windows. And Lord, I pray you pour down. You pour down. You pour down. Abundance of riches. Abundance of blessing upon everyone in Jesus' name. Be glorified and exalted in our midst, that Lord, everyone will remember what you do for them this wonderful day. Thank you, Lord, because we know you have answered. In Jesus' name we pray. God bless you. You can sit down in the blessing of God. Looking at this important message that will roll away every problem, every infirmity, every obstacle out of your life and out of your family. We're looking at the message, ever increasing faith and power. Ever increasing faith and power. From Luke chapter 17. Luke chapter 17. I'm reading from verse 5. And the apostle said unto the Lord, increase our faith. The apostles of the Lord, you know them, 12 of them, the disciples, they had met challenges in life, personal challenges, ministerial challenges, domestic family challenges, social challenges with interaction with those Pharisees and Sadducees and their neighbors, national challenges that affected the nation and of course affected each of them. And they have met challenges in ministry that they could not resolve. Because of that, when they saw all that they were facing, they came to the Lord, and the Lord has said something that they felt they needed more of the grace of God. They needed more of the power of God. They needed more of the touch, the transforming touch of the Lord, and the sustaining touch, the mighty, powerful touch of the Lord. Because of that, they came unto the Lord. In that verse 5, and the apostles said unto the Lord, increase our faith. If those apostles could pray like that, and they could ask the Lord that what they wanted was an increase of their faith, so that they'll be able to have an increase of power, an increase of authority, an increase of anointing, an increase of unction, an increase in their success, an increase in their effectiveness. If those apostles could pray like that, asking for an increase of their faith, which will affect every other area of their lives, then you and I, everyone around, everyone listening, ought to be able to say with those apostles, Lord, we have the same need in our personal lives, the same challenges in our family domestic situation, and we have the same problem, the same hurdle in our social interactions with people. We have the same problem and the same things that stir us in the faith, in ministry. If they too could come and say, Lord, increase our faith, we too should come unto the Lord. And we should say unto the Lord in the same way, Lord, increase our faith. You know, they didn't just say increase our faith. The first of all said, Lord, if he is going to increase our faith, number one, we must belong to him, saved by his grace, cleansed by his blood, forgiven by his mercy, and drawn into the kingdom by that cord of love from Calvary. And then there is a submission of our lives unto him, that we're able to say, you are my Lord, you are my master, I give my heart, my life, my will, my body, my soul, my spirit, everything unto you, in total subjection and submission. And then we're able to call him Lord. That means we pledge our loyalty, our faithfulness, our obedience unto him, because he said, why do you call me Lord, Lord, and do not the things which I say? Which means then we start there, surrender and yield our lives unto the Lord. Then we're able to say, he is my Lord, he is my Savior, he is my Redeemer, he is my King. And then with that understanding, and then with that submission to the Lord, we call him Lord. And increase our faith. Can you say that with me? Lord, increase our faith. Say that again. Say it from the very depth of your heart. When your faith is increased, your confidence will increase. The power of God in your life will increase. The authority of the Spirit in your life will increase. When your faith is increased, things will just move around you. You say the word and it is fulfilled. And then you command and it is done. And you make a request from heaven and it is given unto you. That's why it's so important, as we think about and talk about and look at this important message, ever increasing faith and power. I divide the message into three parts. Number one, the glorious power of an incorruptible faith. There is a kind of faith that is incorruptible, that Satan cannot touch, that the world cannot resist, that the powers of darkness cannot challenge. It is incorruptible. The glorious power of an incorruptible faith. Number two, the great power of an all-inclusive faith. That is the kind of faith that doesn't know any restricted area. All-inclusive, anywhere, in any life, in any place. This faith is all-inclusive. And it includes you today. Your problems are solved in Jesus' name. the great power of an all-inclusive faith. Number three, the growing power of an increasing faith. The faith is increasing. The power is growing. The growing power of an increasing faith. Number one, the glorious power. Number two, the great power. Number three, the growing power. Number one, the glorious power of an incorruptible faith. This is the faith of the Lord Himself that He gives unto us. And because it belongs to the Lord, and the Lord has given that to us as a gift, whatever comes from the Lord is incorruptible. His word is incorruptible. Gift is incorruptible. His power is incorruptible. And the faith that comes from Him, coming from the very throne of God, and coming from the very heart of God, and coming unto us, that faith is incorruptible. And He passes it on unto us. And it gives us a glorious power, a glorious authority, and a glorious possession. We're looking at Romans chapter 1. Romans chapter 1, verse 16 and verse 17. Romans chapter 1, verse 16. For I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ. Remember, anything coming from Christ, anything coming from God, anything coming from the Spirit of God is incorruptible. The glorious power of an incorruptible faith. I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, for it is the power of God unto salvation. You look at the people that God saved, turned their lives around. You're thinking about Saul of Tarsus, how God took hold of that man, and the gospel came to him on the road to Damascus. All of a sudden, this incorruptible faith came into his heart, and then it led him to the grace of God, the gospel of Christ, and the salvation. And because that faith is incorruptible, you see, the transforming power, the glorious power, and a kind of power that all his persecutors could not stop. That's why now he declared and he proclaimed, he said, I am not ashamed. You will not be ashamed. You will not be ashamed of the gospel. You will not be ashamed of Christ. You'll not be ashamed of your salvation. You will not be ashamed of the glorious gospel the Lord has given unto us. I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, for it is the power of God unto salvation. When you receive that gospel, when you accept that gospel comes to life, that gospel will make a great transformation, and your life will be literally, totally, completely turned around. That gospel will work in your life in Jesus' name. That's why the very place you start is when you have this dynamic world, this life-changing gospel, and this mighty, powerful gospel that turns lives around. And I pray the effect of that gospel, the power of that gospel, the fruit-producing gospel, I pray it will be effective in your life. And something great, something wonderful will happen. A change of life, a change of character, a change of disposition, a change that includes every area of your life, from the inside, outside. It will happen in Jesus' name. It happened to Paul, it was Saul. God changed change that man, he changed him from Saul and changed him to Paul. That's the effect of the gospel. And it begins with this basic, incorruptible faith that leads us into this glorious salvation that is wrought within us by the glorious power of the Lord. You will not miss it. I said you will not miss it. The first manifestation of glorious power in the life of anyone that manifests this incorruptible faith is that change of life. It becomes a new creature. Old things are passed away, and behold, all things. How many things? Said how many things? Asking how many things? All things have become new. Let me go back to that. Romans chapter 16. Why not ashamed of the gospel of Christ? For it is the power of God to salvation. To everyone, to everyone, to everyone. That means as you are there, it will come on you. I said it will come on you. Because this is for everyone that believeth. What do you believe? You manifest faith and confidence and trust. It is that faith, incorruptible faith, that leads you into believing the Lord with a heart that is so dependent upon the Lord, trusting the Lord for your salvation, eternal salvation. For everyone that believeth, to the Jew first and also to the Greek. And then in verse 17, for therein is the righteousness of God revealed from faith to faith. You see what that faith does? Do you see the change, the transformation? Do you see the impact and the effect, the power of that faith in our lives? And it says, it is this faith, this incorruptible faith, that brings the righteousness, the power of the Almighty God into our lives. And it says, it's from faith to faith, as it is written, the just shall live by faith. You will live by faith. I said you will live by faith. That's where we begin, trusting the Lord. Because of this incorruptible faith, I pray the Lord will give that incorruptible faith. And what that incorruptible faith will produce in your life will be corruptible in Jesus' name. In John chapter 1. John chapter 1. I'm in verse 12. John 1 verse 12. But